moving on to a more compelling subject when it comes to a former high school graduate out of Texas, Ryan Trahan, that is now at Texas A&M. He is a cross-country and track runner. You know, recently, last week, William Grundy wrote about the fact that, you know, he has a water bottle company that he has developed, and now he's trying to make money from. Still in college, still an athlete, and now the NCAA is cracking down on some of the things he's doing with YouTube and just his business in general. So, we have some thoughts about this.
Yeah, we do.
We have
I have thoughts.
We have maybe Travis going to be arguing on the side of the NCAA.
Yeah, you know, this is a company he started in high school with his friend, now a freshman NCAA. It seems like this has been a shocking situation to him going through this, but it's pretty straightforward. You know, if we look at what the exact NCAA wording is, student athletes may establish his or her own business, provided the student athlete's name, photograph, appearance, or athletics reputation are not used to promote the business. That's pretty cut and dry. And so the fact that this is this came out of nowhere, it's pretty this shouldn't be a shocking situation. To me, it's not a story. Yeah, it's pretty straightforward what the NCAA rules are, what their guidelines are, what they will and will not allow athletes to do. And that's what he is doing with his company. And whether or not we agree with it, you got to be ahead of these kind of things. I think you got to recognize that this was coming and just be in front of it. And the NCAA has been pretty lenient with giving him the ability. Just you got to separate the two. You got to separate not leverage your position as an athlete to sell your products. And that is pretty cut and dry. And in terms of NCAA eligibility, those are things you just need to know in and out. You just need to understand those things, know the situations you're going into, and you just got to be ahead of it.
First of all, this is completely a story. Every time this happens with an athlete, it is a story. We can't brush this under the rug just because, you know, the NCAA has rules, right? Yeah. The rules may be wrong in the first place. The NCAA, to some, is the big bad villain, right? Because of, let's see, NCAA as a whole profits from sports enterprises, right? They make billions of dollars off of their sports programs and, broadcasting sports and teams as a whole, right? Yeah. They make billions of dollars from sports. And here is Ryan Trahan starting a business. You go to college to learn about business, to form opinions, and to learn about the free market. So he's forming a business, and he's trying to make money. So NCAA profits off the likenesses sometimes of their athletes to make millions. He's trying to profit off his own likeness. He should have authority over his own likeness to sell his water bottles. Now, my point would be, there's got to be a middle ground somewhere. We got to produce sort of a cap or a regulation that allows athletes that have great ideas and want to make money to ultimately pursue their goals. And I think selling water bottles as a whole is a hard business. Like, everybody sells water bottles. Like, he's not making a lot of money through this. So I think the NCAA,
there was a report either in Washington Post or somewhere else that said he's made over $50,000 in the last year on his company.
By Ryan Trahan?
By Ryan Trahan. And they're not telling him he can't do it. They never said you can't do this.
Use his likeness is what they're saying.
And your position as an NCAA athlete to sell water bottles.
The point is he should have his own authority over his own likeness, right? To do whatever he wants with it, right? He is an athlete of Texas A&M, but he owns his own likeness. So if he sells a water bottle, that should be under his own purview because that's him. He's a business owner.
What do you guys think? You know, we're live on Facebook right now. Trent's taking in comments. But if you're watching live or you're watching after the show, tweet at us, hashtag MilesBitLive. We want to know what your thoughts are because it's definitely a hot topic regardless of what end of the spectrum you're on. Everyone has an opinion on this. Where do you see that moving forward?
I see the NCAA cracking down like they always do. And I see Ryan Trahan making his business to fit certain parameters. But I feel like, you know, it's almost impossible sometimes to fight this fight because the NCAA has all these lawyers and people who can kind of bury you. But Ed O'Bannon made a great case against, NCAA and EA Sports a while back, but he pursued it. But it takes time, it takes money, it takes effort. So is it really worth it for a college athlete? I mean, he'll probably just do what he has to do to keep the business, but under the guidelines as he's a college athlete.
Yes, he has to separate the two. He can promote his company across social media, but it has to be on a separate channel from his athletics-related social media account, and that's in order to gain. He did not have eligibility. That's the steps he needs to take to gain back his eligibility to run.
The fact that even his eligibility came into question is baffling to me. I mean, the guy.
I mean, that to me is less of an issue. It's like you have to understand that. You have to understand that going to college, any athlete going into the NCAA system needs to understand everything that's at work there. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's at fault with him, what kind of information was provided to him once he got to Texas A&M, but those kind of things got to come out of the woodworks pretty quickly. And for this, not a lot of athletes are in his situation. Not a lot of athletes have this side company they started, which is an incredible entrepreneurial enterprise from him. You got to give him credit as a high school athlete starting that, but you got to know, as you know, whatever organization you're in at with the school, you have to be pulling the kind of information out of the athletes to make sure you're getting in front of it. To me, when I heard it, this whole thing is a surprise coming out of nowhere, I'm like, man, there was a ball dropped somewhere down the line.
You have compliance officers at Texas A&M. They should have known where your business was, and obviously I don't know where that's at, but I mean, obviously he should have people at Texas A&M kind of guiding him through this process.
And I think they did as soon as they figured out, like, this could be breaking the rules potentially. So
Seemed like both them and the NCAA tried to find a solution. Yeah. And whether or not you agree with it, or certainly Ryan, it's not his ideal solution.
Yeah. Right.
You know, his ideal solution, because he has a YouTube channel, he does his videos, blogs within the Texas A&M, but he can no longer include his company within that. Which is definitely a tough position. I mean, how do you see that for college athletes, that it's free reign to operate as you wish?
No, I think there should be a regulated cap, as I said, to help athletes pursue their dreams, right? And that could be business-oriented, it could be anything, starting your own YouTube channel, but there should be caps based upon how much you can earn, right? And once you get past a certain cap, maybe, you know, you need to stop or something, but there should be some type of incentive programs by, you know, your colleges, your NCAA, to help these athletes who have creative minds, allow them to pursue them. So
yeah, if you've dealt with a similar situation, let us know what your ideas are. What are your solutions? And we'll compile some of our great best answers we get across social media. Tweet at us, Facebook. Let us know what you think and how the NCAA and athletes could come to a compromise here to move forward.